Whether you're new to the gym, or maybe you're returning back to the gym after some time away, or you could even be an experienced lifter, I find the number one question that a lot of people have is how to best organize their training over the week to really ensure that they're making the most of their time in the gym and optimizing their fitness goals. And the best way to actually make sure that you're training the most effectively that you can be is to have a really effective and optimal training split. And a training split can be defined as a detailed plan and organized way of actually how you plan to spread out your workouts over the given week and which muscle groups are going to be worked on which days. So in today's video, I'm going to be covering the four most common training splits, with them being the bro split, the full body split, the upper-lower split, and the push-pull leg split. I'm going to be giving the advantages and disadvantages, and at the end, I'm going to be giving the verdict to actually which training split is the best for you in 2020. Starting off with the bro split, this is probably the most common training split that a lot of people jump to when they're really looking to optimize their muscle building process. And how the bro split works for those who aren't familiar, basically what you're doing is you're giving each muscle group its own separate day. So on Monday you would do chest, on Tuesday you would do back, and then shoulders and arms and legs. So basically you're just separating each day into one specific muscle group. During my first year and a half of training consistently and really working out, this was actually the split that I followed, and I feel like a lot of people jump to it as well. And I think there's two main reasons to why people jump to it, with that being that you see a lot of competitive bodybuilders following it, so therefore I think it's gained its popularity through just bodybuilders and just Jay Cutler and people that are just training to become Mr. Olympia. I think that gets the reputation up and people think that it's the best split. And another reason is that I actually seen some pretty impressive gains during that time. So that's really the two reasons why I started following it, was because I've seen other bodybuilders doing it and I was really liking the results. As I began to educate myself more and more in health and fitness, I slowly realized that the bro split might not be the most optimal approach for training for me. And honestly, this is what the question that I really want to answer today is the bro split really the most optimal for you? And I'm going to be giving the advantages and disadvantages. And like I mentioned at the end of the video, after I review the other training splits, I'm going to be giving the verdict. But I do want to go over the advantages, because I feel like with any training split, there are advantages and there are disadvantages. So the first advantage that I want to go over in terms of the bro split is that you're actually only training one muscle group per session, and this can make your sessions a little bit more manageable, and you can really get a pretty impressive pump. And honestly, I love the feeling of the pump. And if you're just going in and working one muscle, it just really feels great going in and kind of destroying that muscle. In your mindset, I found that when I first started doing it, I was able to get in the mindset of actually psyching myself up to really go in and train my chest as hard as I could. So it was really enjoyable from that standpoint, that I didn't have to worry about training other muscle groups and I could just focus on one. And the second advantage that I want to go over is that it's actually a really enjoyable way to train, like I mentioned. I think that's very important in terms of following any training split, whatever one you choose. You definitely want it to be enjoyable, because if you don't enjoy your style of training or what split you're following, then it's going to really decrease your adherence to that program, and it's going to make the gym more of a nuisance as opposed to something that you enjoy doing. Now moving on to the disadvantages of the bro split. And the bro split is actually a very volume focused training split. It prioritizes training volume over frequency and intensity. And this can definitely become a problem, because it's very easy to go and when you're training chest and do 20 sets. And 20 sets per session is a little bit too much, depending on how you recover. But for most people, you don't want to be going out and doing 20 sets per session of chest training. So actually, by spreading out your volume, if you're only, like I said, if the definition of the training split is that you're hitting one muscle group per day, so your focus is on one, so you're training chest, then you're training back. If you were to actually take that training and spread it out multiple times per week, so you're going to train chest twice per week and back twice per week in a different style split, which I will go over, you're actually able to increase your body's ability to enter muscle protein synthesis and actually increase your body's ability to build muscle. So from a standpoint of actually volume related, it's really good for getting volume in, but volume might be too much and you're not able to actually get the frequency needed and the intensity. I would just like to further expand on why you actually are sacrificing intensity with the bro split, and that's because, like I mentioned previously with that example with chest, if you're going in there and you're doing 20 sets of chest in one workout, that's going to consist of, it might consist of 5 or 6 different exercises, and what's going to happen is that during the first 3 exercises, you're really able to push yourself, you're really able to get that progressively overload on the exercises and really try to challenge yourself from workout to workout. But what's going to happen is once you get to the 4th exercise, you're really going to be drained, you're really going to be tired, and it's really going to be impacted the workout intensity, how much weight you're actually able to use, your form is going to start to break down, and really you're not really optimizing your progress, and you're not really optimizing your strength in those exercises. exercises. So I think that from an intensity standpoint, it's really lacking, and you're really better off spreading out, maybe doing, like I said before, spreading out your weekly volume and doing chest twice per week, and doing, if you're doing six exercises in one session, take those and split them up, do three exercises your first session and three exercises your second session. And what you're able to do when you do that is you're able to actually give it your all in those exercises, and you're really able to put your full efforts and really train with a higher intensity. When trying to decide between the next three training splits I'm about to cover, you really need to take into consideration your training experience, your goals, and definitely your time commitment. These should be all factored into the decision on ultimately which one is best for you. So now with that being said, I'd like to cover the full body training split. And how you set up the full body training split is you're training your full body three times a week with a rest day in between. So just like with any training split, like I previously mentioned, there are advantages and there are disadvantages. So I'd like to highlight some of the key ones. The advantages of the full body training split is that it's actually really great for beginners, because as a beginner, your main goal should be really to build some type of foundational strength. And this is actually done through your main compound lifts. So your squat, your bench press, your overhead press, and your deadlifts. So by training three times a week, you're able to actually go in and focus on progressing in those lifts. And really learning the form, I think that it's really great to really take the time, and by doing them more often, you're able to actually master the form quicker, and it's actually really recovery focused, so you're going to be able to have, you're going to be able to prioritize recovery, really allowing your body to get used to being able to handle more load and heavier loads, and as it gets used to it, you're going to be able to recover quicker. But I think it's really great from a recovery standpoint, and to really learn to master the form and really get those main compounds in at the same time. Now moving on to the disadvantages of the full body training split. So as a beginner lifter, you're building that foundational strength as I previously mentioned, but as you actually graduate from that program and your body's able to handle more volume and more training frequency, you're going to need to be able to have to find ways to actually increase that by training more frequently. So that's why I feel as an intermediate to an advanced lifter, it might not be the most ideal training split. And coming from a bodybuilding perspective as well, you do need some direct isolation work in order to kind of bring up different areas. It's always nice to have your compounds and your isolation exercises. And if you're just training a full body training split, then you might have a problem actually figuring out how to add those into your program. Therefore, you're gonna have to try to find ways to increase your volume and your frequency, which is probably done better through another different program that I'm gonna be covering. But yeah, going back to the bodybuilding perspective, I think there's also weak points that you need to bring up. So it's gonna be really hard to find that training time to do that in a full body training split. And sometimes your workouts just might end up being way too long. So that's why spreading out your workouts and adding a couple extra days through a different style training split might be a little bit more advantageous. So now moving on to the next training split option, and that's actually the upper lower training split. And as the name implies, it separates your training into two different days, being the upper day and the lower day. And honestly, this is a really great progression from the full body training split, because once you get used to the full body training split with the volume, you're able to actually increase it with the upper lower split by adding that extra day. So you're actually going from three training sessions a week to four training sessions per week, and you're still able to really prioritize recovery by having an adequate amount of rest days. The advantages of the upper-lower training split actually include that since you're bumping frequency up from three training sessions to four training sessions, this actually allows you to trigger muscle protein synthesis more during the week, which will ultimately allow you to build more muscle in the long term. So that's the first advantage that I like to cover. The second advantage is that since it goes along with frequency as well, since you're able to actually get that extra training session in, you're able to spread out your volume a little bit more. And by doing so, you're actually able to start adding some more, a good mix of isolation exercises on top of your compound movements, to really make sure that you're getting the full development of each muscle. So the main disadvantage of the upper-lower training split is that you actually run the risk of only training each muscle group once per week, except for legs, because you do have two leg training sessions. But what I mean by this is on your upper days, if you don't properly plan the muscle groups that you're training and the exercise sequencing, what could happen is on upper day one, you could go in, you could train chest and shoulders, and then the next, on your upper day two, which would be 2 days later, you would go in and you would train your back and arms, then you're really only hitting one muscle group per week. You're only training your chest once per week, your arms once per week, your back and your shoulders. So really making sure that you're able to kind of plan for that, and making sure that if you have weak points and different muscle groups that you want to prioritize, that you schedule them in to make sure you're getting the frequency of two times per week. But just on that note, I'd also like to mention that another disadvantage is by trying to do so, you might be cramming too much into your workouts and adding too much unnecessary volume, leading to a kind of overtraining. And it can also make your workouts really lengthy. So I feel like these are the two major disadvantages. And now for the final training split, which is the push-pull legs training split. And what this split does is it actually separates the muscle groups that share similar functions and really splits them up nicely. So what I mean by this is on your push days, you're gonna be training your chest, your shoulders, your triceps. On your pull days, it's gonna be your back and your biceps. And obviously your leg days, you're gonna be training your legs, which consists of your quads, your hamstrings, your glutes, and your calves. The advantage of the push-pull leg training split is I feel like it's the most effective way to group your muscles because you're doing it based off the functions that they perform. And by doing this, you're actually able to increase your frequency while making sure that you're getting that rest time. So it's a nice balance between increasing your training frequency, spreading out your volume, and really making sure that you're prioritizing recovery. And it really allows for that 48 hours in between training sessions. We all know how important recovery is because when you're actually training, that's not when you're doing the growing. It's when you're resting and you're away from the gym that you're doing the growing. So that's why also getting proper nutrition and sleep is very important on top of this whole process. And I like to further expand on the training frequency aspect of it. So basically what you're able to do is you're able to actually train each muscle group twice per week. And so by doing so, it allows you to spread out the volume. And like I mentioned before, you're prioritizing recovery by actually spreading out the volume. There's a lot of different options that are available to you in terms of like the flexibility of it. So I feel like the flexibility of the program is really great. And if you have weak points that you want to target, you're able to actually prioritize those in your training split because you're training more often. So I feel like this is a very good training split for anyone who's intermediate or advanced. So the disadvantage of the push-pull leg training split is that it might not be ideal for beginners. And the reason why is because you're actually increasing that training frequency and you're spreading out the volume, and by doing so, a beginner lifter might run into recovery issues and not be able to progress in strength and find that they're kind of doing a little bit of overtraining. So I think that is quite a bit of a jump for a beginner lifter. And another thing that I want to bring up that I feel is very important in terms of the split and why it might not be ideal is because it does sacrifice intensity. Because you're actually trying to increase that training frequency and you're trying to train multiple times per week and you're trying to get that up and you're spreading out your volume, then something has to take the hit, and honestly it's intensity. You can't be going in there and training all out every single workout, because what's going to happen is eventually you could run into recovery issues and you're not going to be able to make the strength progressions that you want. So I think that from an intensity standpoint, it might not be ideal. So those are the two main disadvantages, is that it might not be ideal for a beginner lifter, and intensity does take a hit. All right, so now it's time for the verdict on which training split is actually best for you in 2020. And the answer is really simple. It all depends. What does it depend on? It depends on your level of training experience, your goals, your lifestyle, your time commitment, and honestly, which one you're gonna enjoy the most. And you have to kind of experiment with each one to figure out which one you do enjoy the most, because we know that a program and a training split can only be as effective as your ability to stick with it. And if you're following a training split that you don't like, then your chances of sticking with it probably aren't very likely. So you wanna take into consideration all those things when you're making the decision. And personally, I think that it's really great to switch your training splits too. If you're following the same one for anywhere from 3 to 6 months, maybe consider switching. So let's say you're following up or lower for, you've been following it for 6 months, consider switching to a full body workout or training split, or even a push-pull legs. I think by varying your training splits, there's a lot of different benefits in terms of shocking your body, providing your body with new stimulus, and kind of switching the exercises up to make sure that your workouts don't get stale. However, with that being said, I think some training splits do make more sense than others, and which one is actually going to be factored in your decision. And I think that going back to what I said with your training experience, you don't want to be jumping into going from a full body to a push-pull legs if you're not really used to the full body training split. So I think some are more applicable than others. And that's why I'm going to bring up on the screen a quick comparison of all the four training splits that I covered, so you're able to kind of take some notes when deciding on which training split you want to follow for 2020. Video on the best training split for you in 2020. I think the most important thing is just that following something that you're consistent with and working hard and something that you enjoy doing. I guarantee if you keep those things in mind when you're training and you're really deciding on the split that you want to follow for 2020, I guarantee that you'll see the results that you want to see. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I do have a lot of great content that's in the works and I'm really excited to share with you guys. So don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Also turn on the bell for notification to make sure you get notified every time I drop a new video. And for those who are new or returning to my channel, I do consistently upload twice a week, so you can expect videos every Sunday and every Wednesday. Also give the video a like, it helps support my channel. I'm trying to grow my channel. A lot of work goes into making the videos, so I'd really appreciate it if you could give it a thumbs up. And that's gonna do it. Until next time, peace out.